杨先生他有事情要先走，所以我对不起，我调整一下顺序，我请因为麦克风先生先简短的回应他一下哈。那我们现在就麻烦请那个 Michael Snyder 简短的回应一下刚刚杨宪宏先生讲的关于这个可能是一个新的思考方式，到底他的一些评论是什么？谢谢。
Thank you very much. Well, I think it's exactly as was said. This is actually not a new development. It's been under research for a long time, and there are actually pretty clear reasons also why it has not been successful. First of all, I think that the resource constraint that could lead to interest in thorium is not happening. It's like with plutonium. It was thought that uranium would become a scarce resource, and therefore plutonium reactors and thorium reactors were particularly thought of interest. This is not the case. As we've seen, the world nuclear reactor fleet is rather going down than up. At the same time, we have more uranium resources that have been identified than we thought of earlier. Finally, I think that the key problems of uranium fissile reactors are not solved by thorium reactors. If the weapons usability of thorium is not the same as for high-enriched uranium or plutonium, there is a phase of uranium-233, which is another fissile material. You can actually make bombs with uranium-233. So it also generates nuclear wastes. So I don't think it really solves the basic fundamental problems of nuclear generation as we know it with light water reactors mainly around the world today.
Well, 非常谢谢那个 Michael 先生给这简短的评论哈。其实我这几天跟Michael 我们到好多地方去拜访，我也听了他很多的东西哈。就是说刚刚杨宪宏先生提的是很多能源思考的一些不一样的方向，那不过他好像都会有个类似的问题，就是那个能源的这种集中化跟去集中化的一些思维的不一样，所以说不定等一下我们还可以有进一步的讨论跟分享。那我们第二位邀请到今天的一起来语谈的其实是我跟刚刚我们提那个